Today we are diving into something super interesting in the world of AI. It's like assembling your own team of Avengers, but in the digital world. I'm talking about Autogen Studio's latest release. You can now run more than two agents, kinda like going from playing duets to conducting a full orchestra, and each agent can use different LLMs and have specific skills. These skills are nothing else than Python functions assigned to an agent. Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. I am Donna, a software engineer and AI specialist based in Sydney, and in this video I will show you how to set up and use the latest version of Autogen Studio. At the end of this video, you will be able to run your own team of agents and create your own workflow to perform any tasks or list of tasks. The good news is that you don't need to know how to code, and you can run the workflow for free as well if you use local LLMs. We are going to use an example where I create two agents, one that can retrieve all the comments from a YouTube video, and another agent that can use these comments to generate new video ideas. As always, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to keep yourself updated in the latest AI trends, and give a thumb up to support the channel. Also, let me know in the comments what you would use this for in your daily life. Now let's dive into the installation process. The installation is pretty straightforward, as you can just run two commands: pip install Autogen Studio, and then Autogen Studio UI --port 8081. Autogen can be directly accessed through your browser by going to the 0.0.0.0, double dot, and your port, which is 8081 in my case. Now let's talk about the build tab. One of the tabs you have here is models. As its name indicates, this is where you can define multiple models. To add a new model, simply click on New Model in the top right. If you want to add GPT-4, for example, you will need to add the model name GPT-4 1106 preview, the API key that you get directly from platform.openai.com, and the base URL, which is in this case https://api.openai.com/v1. You also have the option to click on Test Model to see if everything is set up correctly. You can use LLMs like GPT-4 preview, but you can also use local LLMs like Olama or any model that you can run with LLM Studio. If you want to learn more about how to run your own LLM locally, I made a video about it that will appear just here. Once your LLM is run on LLM Studio, you can add it there as the name. You don't need an API key, and the base URL would be http://localhost followed by the port and /v1. You can then add a description that will appear in the card in the model list. Now that I have created my model, I can go to the Skills tab. Skills allow you to create a new skill for an agent, which is a simple Python function. It will be possible to add that skill to an agent. Here I will add my function, which is a function that will take a YouTube video ID as parameter and return the list of all the comments for that video. To make this simpler, I directly added the YouTube API key inside the function. Here I put the name of the function for the name of the skills. And don't worry if you don't know how to code, you can simply ask ChatGPT-4 with the following prompt. This is an example of a function that has been written before. And here you put the example of one of the functions that you have by default on Autogen. Write a function to get all of the YouTube comments from a video. You will let me know if you need any API key and the necessary steps to get it. You will get the step-by-step process to get the API key and also the function written. I ran into the issue when adding spaces in the skill name, so I would advise you to keep it with the snake case like here, and you can simply put the name of the function. Now that the skill is added, I can go to the next part, the agents. See agent like an expert in a domain or someone part of a team. I could use the same metaphor that I used in my previous video about mixture of expert that you can find in the description of this video. Here I will create two agents. Agent number one is going to be called YouTube Assistant, and it is an agent that helps with anything YouTube related. In the future, I can add other skills like fetching the transcript of a video or fetching the description of a specific video. In the system message, I will say the following. Given a video idea, you will use the Get YouTube Comment skill to return the list of comments for that video. In model, you can decide which model to use, and in this case, I will use GPT-4, but you also have the option to use the local model you created before. This will allow you to save on cost. Then in skills, I can add the skill I created before, get YouTube comments, and finally I can click on OK. Now I can create another agent that I will call Content Generator Assistant as a name. I can add a description, which is based on YouTube video comments, you will return a list of video ideas. I will set the max consecutive auto reply to 2. This is about how many times it can go back and forth before it terminates the conversation. I also set a system message to say, you are a YouTube growth expert with 10 plus years of experience helping small YouTubers to become big. Given a list of YouTube comments, you will return a list of YouTube video ideas. I can then set up the model. And in this case, I don't have a skill for that agent. And here we are. Now I have my 2 agents. And the next step is to create a workflow and add them there. Imagine a workflow like a WhatsApp group where each of the agents are in. In that group, you also have an agent called user proxy. When you post a message in there, the user proxy agent figures out the different steps to do and which agent is the most qualified to perform the first action. A bit like a manager. Then the action is performed and it figures out who can perform the next action and so on until it terminates. So if I go to the workflow tab, I can click on new workflow in the top right. And here I can select group chat, which wasn't available in the previous version. It asks for a name, so I will add YouTube content generator workflow and then a description, which is just a description of the workflow. Then I can see the sender, which is user proxy. Here there is nothing to modify, but I need to include the agents in the receiver. In the group chat assistant. For that, I can click on it. At the top in group chat agents, I removed them all and add my 2 agents I created before. Leave the speaker selection method to auto. The round robin one will just assign the task to the available agent. Random will assign it randomly. Here we want to make the user proxy decide. Then I will leave all the options as they are. In system message, I will say what is the whole workflow about. You are a helpful assistant that will help generating new content idea. First, you will pass down the video idea to the YouTube assistant agent to use the function to get the list of comments from YouTube. You will then use the content generator assistant to get a list of video content idea and show that list to the user. Finally, I will set the model and I don't need to set any skills as I already set them to each other agent. And that's it, I created my workflow. Now let's see the result and go to the playground tab. I can go to the playground tab, click on new, select my workflow, click on create and write my message. Based on the YouTube video with the ID, following ID, which covers how to build an AI assistant, generate a list of new video content ideas. Now I simply need to wait that it runs. I then get my final answer. If I scroll down and click on agent messages, I can see the different agents called at different times. First, the user proxy that passes on to the YouTube assistant. Then the YouTube assistant that recognizes that it needs to run the get YouTube comments function. And finally, the content generator assistant, where I can see all the comments and the final answer. Based on the comments from the YouTube video, here are some video content ideas that could be generated. Privacy concern and data management, a video addressing how data is managed and kept private when using AI services, as privacy is a concern for some users. Customization and deployment, a tutorial on how to customize and deploy a chatbot using Docker, as there is more interest in more technical implementation focused content. Comparison of GPT versions. A video explaining the differences between various GPT versions and their capabilities, as some users are confused about which version to use. OpenAI Playground versus Custom GPT. A video discussing the pros and cons of using OpenAI Playground versus creating a custom GPT model for personal use. In this case, I used my own YouTube video, so I don't have hundreds of comments. But it works, as we can see here. And this is a quick and simple example, but there are thousands of other use cases that I could include here. I could create another agent to get all the YouTube videos links of my channel and another agent to transform the YouTube video links and extract the ID. That would help to get even more videos ideas from all of the videos. I could also create agent helping out building the description of my video or fetching the transcript and creating a blog post. Let me know in the comment what you will do now that you can run your own team of agents. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. You can also book a consulting call with me with the link in the description of my video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.